A great scientific experiment begins.
Try another frequency. What is it?
Something's jamming the wavelengths.
Gifting stuff exists prehistoric times. I mean, actually, you know that there's stuff discovered from 40,000 years ago in Africa, and, where gift exchanges were occurring from eggshells that were a little bit beautified. And so that exists. However, that's not the same thing as barter. Okay?
Yeah.
Barter would be at the same time I give you a gift and you give me one. Okay? Okay, if you have a simultaneous exchange, that's barter. That's not the way economy started. There's a very good work done by Hudson, Michael Hudson, and by Graeber called Debt, the First 5,000 Years. And he has convinced me, they both have convinced me that in fact the barter is not, it's one of the mythologies that have been developed in economics to give some historical perspective on it, which is in fact not true. That's not the way things have started. The gift exchange is actually when I give you something and you owe me something, but you don't cancel it off now. Okay? So I have a credit with you, ethical credit, relationship credit, so that you will feel uncomfortable if I need something to refuse it. And this could become very important, you know, in relatively primitive societies. It can be a question of survival, right? If I don't have a glass of water now and you happen to have some, that's it. Or you have fire and I don't, okay? That can make a big difference in life, right? So these the gift exchange is actually not an exchange. There is a counter gift that's left open, okay? While a commercial transaction, actually, when I finish buying something, there is nothing is owed me, and you know, we're clean. There is no relationship build up. Well, the best work done on the gift economy and the gift mechanism is by Mauss, who is a French anthropologist back in the 1920s and 30s. He created the theory of the gift. And his approach is, when you make an exchange, there's actually, when I make you a gift, there is a counter gift that is not manifesting. There's an imbalance between the two. And that imbalance that actually makes an investment from my side that you may be more positively oriented towards me in the future. And therefore, in the future, there will be something happening. In a mutual credit system, the difference is that there are two aspects. In a mutual credit system, I am not indebting me to you. It's not an individual process. It's a process towards a community that uses that currency. Okay? If I give you a gift, that doesn't mean that your brother owes me. Okay? Even your brother, okay? You may have to have a conversation with him to convince him that there is something there. But it is not automatic. Which is well the case in a mutual credit system. It's not a commitment between the two of us. So that's the first thing. Okay? And the second thing is, the credit is given now. Okay? In other words, I do have, it is completed now between us. Okay? And I can get back from other people in the community. That's not the way it is in a gift mechanism. So that's the differences. The commonality is that they're both yin processes. They're both processes to create relationships and strengthen them. But there's relationships with two different types of environments. One is more individual, the other one is more collective.